Okay, so we're here to talk about search, specifically appearance search today. So why is search important? A good example of this would be, think about how we use the internet today through your web browser. Imagine that you could use the internet, but you had no access to a service like Google, enabling you to search for specific things that you're looking for, to find sites, to find information. You can imagine how things would be that much more time consuming, that much harder for you to do things without having a search engine available to you, but also knowing that an abundance of information is available at the tip of your hands, if only you could search for it, if you only could find that needle in a haystack. Well, that's why we need search. If you think about video, we have more cameras, so we are able to collect a lot more information. Cameras are coming at higher and higher resolution, so we're able to get more detail, more information from these cameras, from this data. We're able to store information, valuable information, for much longer because storage is becoming more affordable these days. So collecting more data and being able to store this more data for an extended period of time is useful only if you can actually take advantage of it, to use it in some manner. Only 5% of video is actually ever used. 95% of video is never actually touched, never sort of looked at in any particular way. And the reason for that is human attention is at a premium. It takes us time to find information that we want in video. So it's just like having the power of the internet at your hands, but without the Google at your disposal, everything takes that much longer. And given that human attention, human resources that are at a premium, unless there's a real need for you to be looking at video, no one ever does. Yet, we spend a lot of money both collecting video and storing it for an extended period of time. But time is important. If we want to make security not just a reactive task, but also a proactive task, that involves decisive action. And decisive action requires that we understand who, when, where, and what associated with any given event. And we want to understand that quickly, but most importantly, when you're thinking about events that span a site, you don't just want to know what's happening in the field of view of a single camera, you want to know what's happening in your entire site. So being able to search for events, search for actors that participate in the events fast, quickly, so that you can figure out what happened and figure out what action you need to take, well, that's very important in order for us to be able to facilitate proactive security. So let's solve the problem at hand. And one of the key problems that we have is really the scarcity of human attention, as we just talked about. And one way to augment that attention gap, that attention deficit, so to speak, is by adding the power of artificial intelligence. And the goal of artificial intelligence in this case is to filter out everything that is uninteresting so that human attention can be focused on only those things that are truly important, the things that we need the human brain to say, this is an important event, this is someone who is doing a bad thing at my site, I need to react, I need to be able to do something proactively, I need to understand the intention of that user. Those are the things that we want human attention focused at. We don't want them focused on just arbitrary things that are happening in the scene that have no relevance to the important event. So that's why we need search, and search is one of those things that makes the task of being able to find and understand events in a site fast, and fast enough that we can actually take action on it. And search has been actually around for many years now in the context of video surveillance. Time-based searches are a basic feature that is available pretty much in every video surveillance system that's out there. Motion-based searches, probably the next most sophisticated after time, is also available in pretty much every single video surveillance system out there. And more recently, with the more sort of common occurrence of video analytics in the market, we're also able to not just search by motion, but really search by activity. Activity involving not just anything that moves, but perhaps person and vehicles who move, and also understanding whether those persons and vehicles are doing something that is interesting, whether they're loitering for a certain amount of time, whether they are congregating or coming together in groups in ways that you want to pay attention to. So searching by activity is also becoming something that is more and more common. But one of the things that is critical and the foundational step for us to go from single camera-based searches to site-wide searches is being able to search for the presence of a single actor who's involved in an important event, not just within the single camera, but across all the cameras in the site. And it's searching by a given actor. And in many cases, we do not have the resolution or we do not have the detail available to facilitate a biometric search, like a face-based search, on every single individual in the scene. But we do understand what a person looks like. You might be able to describe what a person looks like, and based on that description, somebody else may be able to find that individual or find at least everyone who looks like that individual. And we want to facilitate the same thing, but instead of it being a manual process, we want to facilitate an automatic process. And that's really searching by actor. And as I said, what this actor-based search enables is that it helps you go beyond the limits of a single camera. We can actually start talking about site-wide intelligence. You can ask the question, what did this individual do in my site? As opposed to asking the question, what did this individual do just within the field of view of my single camera? The second question, what a person did within the field of view of a single camera, is an important question, but it's not as powerful as being able to say, did this person do something I'm interested in across my entire site? And that's what site-wide intelligence happens is important for, and that's why appearance search is a foundational step to enable site-wide intelligence. Now, enabling site-wide intelligence, enabling appearance search, and enabling it so that it performs accurately and efficiently, and the total cost of the system is something that is effectively something that we can use in the mainstream, the mass market, without needing supercomputers or without having to spend a huge amount of money on servers. We need to be able to architect a full solution in a way where computation, in a way where intelligence is spread through the entire solution, not just in bits and pieces. And it starts with a collection of data. And one of the things that we have to emphasize is being able to collect data at a high enough resolution, be able to collect it with a high enough clarity such that we can actually understand and be able to describe it with artificial intelligence. So step one of the three layers that are involved here, layer one among the three layers that are involved here, is really this notion of being able to capture video at a high resolution. And at Avigilon, we have cameras ranging everything from 1 megapixel all the way to 7K or 30 megapixels available to us to do this task. The second is that we not only want to be able to empower the cameras to stream video that are high quality with high resolution, we also want to be able to empower the camera to describe what it is seeing in this high quality video. And that's where analytics comes into play. That's what high definition self-learning analytics comes to play. So it's not just analytics in the traditional sense, but one that can take advantage of the high definition that's available to us in doing its analysis, and one that is self-learning in that if you have 100 cameras, you shouldn't have to manually go configure each one of those 100 cameras. It should be something that configures itself automatically. The output of these two layers is not only a camera that can stream video, it's also a camera that can stream metadata or something that describes the content of that video itself. When you have these two pieces, these two layers, then you can start talking about artificial intelligence that uses this description and starts to analyze what is important. Tries to figure out, these are the events that a human needs to pay attention to. These are the events that we can potentially comfortably ignore. And that comes as the layer that benefits from the analysis that's already being done at each of the cameras. And that analysis can be efficiently done only if the cameras themselves are able to describe what they are seeing. So this is where we get to appearance search. Appearance search is the first step in the artificial intelligence sequence of capabilities that Avigilon is going to release. And this starts with basically understanding who in the scene showed up in your entire site, who this actor is that either did a bad thing, or you just want to understand where they are right now, but across the whole site, not just within the context of a single camera. And that's what appearance search is all about. And sometimes it's really difficult to describe in words what a person looks like, to do so accurately so that you can find that single individual in the entire site. So all you want to be able to do is, for the sake of simplicity, click on a person. And the act of clicking on a person should enable you to find that individual across all your cameras in your entire site. So just as two quick examples, you could click on this person in the scene and say, find all instances of this person in the time that has passed, or perhaps find all the instances of this person forward in time. So maybe ask the question, where is this individual now? Similarly, you can do the same thing with a vehicle. If a vehicle entered your facility and you want to know where that vehicle is now, clicking on that vehicle should enable you to find that vehicle anywhere in your site across all the cameras that you have available to you very quickly and very efficiently so that you can take a proactive decision. Now, this is fundamentally an AI-driven system. It's driven by a fairly sophisticated neural networks, but that neural network is nowhere as powerful as the human brain. The human brain is always going to be able to do better than anything that the neural network is going to do, at least today, given today's computational capabilities. But where such systems really shine is when we have to look through lots of video, where human attention, again, is at a premium, and we want to make sure that things that would be easily missed by a human, not because they're incapable of seeing or finding that individual, but really because in an effort to find that individual quickly, they may miss a small occurrence of that individual. So what you see in this example here is we're looking for this individual in the highlighted corner there. That person shows up way back in the scene there. If you were playing this video very quickly, you would easily miss that person. But when you search using appearance search, you actually get instances of that individual, even though that individual is similarly close to this little boy who you see in the front of the scene at a much higher resolution, who's clearly not the person you're looking for, but is similarly clothed, similar in appearance. You can find the person that you actually are looking for, even though that person shows up all the way in the back of the scene. Being able to do this quickly, efficiently, not just within a single camera, but across all the cameras in your field of view, that's what enables the power of forensic and proactive intelligence, and that's really enabled by appearance search. I can't do it justice by describing it to you, so I would really sort of encourage you to come to our booth, our stand at 2A16, and actually get a demo for yourself, and you'll be able to see exactly what we have in store for you there. Thank you very much.